Hello everyone. Good evening everyone from FTC India. Welcome one and all in the final day of the webinar. FTC being hope and wishes will being of everybody in the coming days of this and everyone coming this day of this pandemic. Hello everyone. Myself Kajal Kumari, Government Polytechnic, Bhaga, Dhanbad, Jharkhand, India, getting the opportunity host and introduce to you all our revamped speaker who are going to represent today's training program. But before you get started, there is a request to everybody. If you have any question during the presentation, as yearly said, please type them into the chat box in your Zoom control panel. Our co-host will bring them up after the presentation, and we will also have time question and the end. So our first speaker is Mr. Biswajit Dev, lecturer MCE Kalyani. Our second presentation, Saurabh Kumar and Sandeep Mukherjee, GP Bhaga Dhanbad. And our third speaker is Rohan Nayak, Rohan Sarkar, Guru Nanak Institute of Technology. Now I would like to request our first presentation speaker, Mr. Biswajit Singh Deb, to present his presentation. Sir?
Hello?
Hello, sir. Are you there?
Yeah.
Sir, yes, sir. Start, sir.
But how to... Can I see my presentation?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I'm going to discuss regarding the high pressure process of perishable foods. Okay. Introduction. Nowadays the consumer demands for high organoleptics and nutritional quality foods. Okay. And for many years, the thermal processing was the main technology, but there is some disadvantage. Okay. In case of thermal processing, there is a flavor or nutrient losses there. Also, the physicochemical properties are affected. Okay. Now, the most recently, the desirable features of the technology, such as to destroy the microorganism or the inactivation of the microorganism enzyme, and second was the minimum losses of flavor and food quality. Okay. And the third one, to avoid or reduce the detrimental changes of the sensory and physical properties. Okay. And the fourth one, the low processing temperature also. Okay. And lower cost also needed. Okay. Fewer the environmental impact. Okay. And superior to traditional technology. These are the requirement. Okay. And next one, the most emerging technology. These are the most emerging technology. Okay, these are all are there. Okay, I am not read. Okay, my topic is the high hydrostatic pressure means high pressure process. Okay, and the high pressure process technology, the high pressure kills the microorganism and preserve the foods. Okay, it was discovered by the Heights 1899. And food technology, realized recently in 1980 that the HPD has the many things, high pressure process technology, many things and offered to food industry. Okay. And the promises to become the new and revolutionary unit operation, the potential for the new generation foods. Okay. And the high pressure process technology can replace or supplement the conventional and thermal processing and the additional of the chemical preservation. And high pressure process treatment is the ethermic decontamination process, which consists of the subject in the packaged food to water pressures from the 100 to 900 megapascal. Okay. And this is the pressure applied the isostatically transmitted. Okay. Inside the pressure. Isostatic means the pressure is equally distributed. Okay. See, these are the piston or these are the cylinder. Okay, these are the diameter and these are the food products. Okay, and the pressure is not directly contact with the food. Okay, it's through the medium. The medium is there. It can be water or various types of oil. Okay, see, this is the high pressure process. Okay, see this picture. Okay, see, these are the cylinder and these are the food products. Sample. Okay, these are pistons and these are the pump by which the fluids, any types of fluids, medium, pressure mediums, okay, put into the cylinder. Okay, and these are the medium tanks. Okay, and this coil is used to reduce the heat or the control the temperature. Okay. And these are the affected, all I have discussed. The high pressure affecting the enzyme or something else. Okay. High pressure processing eliminates the pathogens or self extend the shelf life to reduce the microorganism. Okay, and innovative fresh food products. Oh, okay. Increase the shelf life yields, the convenience, all the food products. Okay, and reduce the sodium products. Cleaning label products also used there. Okay, and the pressure can be taken in the range of 100 megapixel to 1000 megapixel. Okay, you can you can see the these are the picture. Means the two elephants weight is needed there. Okay, see the two elephant is standing on the pistons. Approximately 1000 megapixel is needed. Okay, see the picture. Okay, we preserve the foods or we processed the foods in between 100 to 1000 megapixel. See, and these are the sea level, bottom of the sea level ocean, approximately 100 megapixel. Okay, see, below the sea levels as the pressure is used. Okay, and high pressure processing principles, the most two principles is
that. I'm sorry,
hello,
interrupting you.
Sir,
आपका जो sound आ रहा है वो थोड़ा मतलब छूट छूट के आ रहा है, तो इसलिए
I don't know the exactly the reason behind it. Okay.
Okay, sir.
I don't know actually.
Okay, sir.
Wi-Fi net is there also. I don't know. Okay, can I continue?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, high pressure processing principles two. The basis of two principles. Okay. Isostatic principles. Application of pressure to the intensely and uniformly throughout the sample. Already, I have discussed. Now, uniformly throughout the sample. Okay, and second was the large lateral principles. Okay, in this principle, the reaction resulting in volume changes are the influenced by the high pressure applications. Okay, means the volume also changes, na? Volume also changes in case of if the pressure is increased, then volume also decreases in fixed volume. Okay, the reactions with the volume decreases with the accelerated. Okay, if the volume decreases, then reaction also accelerated. Okay, these are the reaction with volume increase or the suppressed. Okay, the two principles. Okay, and these are the HPP crust of the foods. Okay, see, these are the foods. Okay, how to use the pressure. Okay, throughout the all over the bottle. Okay. See the high pressure process cycles. Okay, package food placed in the vessel firstly, then sealed the vessels and water pumped piston by post. Okay, then the pressure transmitted to the uniformly, and the pressure holding time 30 to 30 minutes. See this one. Already I have discussed. Now see, and the inactivation of pathogens is called as microorganism. Okay, now the depressurizes of vessel and cycle completed. Actually, there are the two or three cycles is there. Okay, firstly we can take 30 second. Okay, then we can take 1 minute, or you can take 120 or 150 seconds. Okay, then the product removed. Okay, see high pressure process how to work actually. These are the food product. Okay, in packaged food product. Okay, these are heating or cooling coils to maintain the temperature. Okay, high pressure process pump is there. Okay, see, already I think you can see the picture, or already you knows already gonna how to perform it. Okay, this one the prepacked product. Okay, these are the oil pump. The pump is medium is pump is there. Okay, okay, in this process food is subjected to the elevated pressure up to 900 megapascal or approximately 9000 atmosphere. Okay, with or without the addition of heat and microwave activations or all the attributes to the achieve desired quality. And the pressure processing can be applied at ambient temperature or higher or lower, and thereby the eliminates their thermally introduce the cooked of flavor. Okay. Advantage: high pressure process can be used for process the both liquid and solid foods, flexible contents. Okay, both foods are used. As the potential treatment, the low acid food. Okay, the treatments of food under the HPP is uniformly and nearly the intense throughout the food products. Okay, it kills the bacteria and almost the elimination the heat damage and the use of chemical preservations. Addition is improving the overall quality of the food products. And high pressure process can be created the ingredients with novel function of properties and allow the use of ingredients that would be the destroyed by conventional heat transfer methods. Okay, and also and offer the high pressure process also as the advantages there. Okay, the specific advantage, the basically so, the shelf life also extend while the keeping the taste and nutrition properties of fresh fruits and vegetables. Okay, the new product development possibility and the product of brand or shelf, and this is the okay, the benefits of high pressure processing for the consumers. For consumers, minimally processed food with no added preservatives. There's no added, we are added some preservatives to extend the shelf life, but in case of HPP, there's no added preservatives there. Okay, no need any types of preservatives. High quality, we have very suggest fruit juice. Okay, improve the digestibility of the milk of the infants. The more the stable products, low volume dairy products, in case of dairy products is the most available processing. Okay, for industry, the improve the process efficiency, the opportunity for the development of new products and also intermediates. Okay, and the design improvements of the HP equipment for the liquids and the solid foods, product that meets the consumer demands for the more natural foods. Okay, effects of HPP on food constituents. See, the casein in skim milk is disturbed by the high pressure. Okay, you know the high pressure, the casein also disturbed, affecting the visual appearance. You can see the visuals. Okay, the fat globules also significantly damaged, you know, and enzymes are not destroyed during the high pressure depasteurization. Thus, the raw cheese might contain the original flavor notes. Okay, yogurts from the pressure treated milks are also creamier than other prepared from the conventional methods. Okay, and the pressure treatments influence the reappearance of the some types of cheese. You can see the combined lethal effects of high pressure and the bacteriocin or niacin or lecithin and our temperature treatments are very promising and in some cases result the prolonged storage stability. Okay, the orange juice. In case of orange juice, the microbial is stable for the least of 21 days, but its organoleptic properties remained while accepted and had flavors and vitamins content similar to the fresh spice juice. Okay, application of high pressure processing. Application of high pressure processing, where it is used, the tempering of the chocolates, gelatinization of starches, blanching of vegetables, tendering of meats. Okay, coagulation of texturizations of fish and meats mines. Okay, all of these are all the needed. Okay, these are the HPP products: jam, jellies, juices. These are the okay. The problem related HPP, expensive compared to the traditional processing. All okay. There is a lot of instruments there. This is there is a high expensive. Okay, further research are affected by HPP consumer papers. These are the components of HPP systems. A pressure vessel is needed and it's closer. Okay, and pressure generation systems are needed. The temperature control device is needed. The material handling system is also needed. Okay, these are the components of high pressure systems. Okay, these are the pressure vessels, all the pressure vessels. Okay, the wire wound, okay, and the vessel plug is there, okay, wire wound, the wire wound is used to control the temperatures, okay. See the pistons, okay, these are the all pressure vessel is there, okay, these are the pressure vessel, okay. Some research is there, okay, to develop the continuous process at low capital opening cost is there. Maximum 100 megapixel diameter and length of the pressure vessel, diameter of pressure vessel, length of the pressure vessel, and the volume there for 100 megapixel is okay, and for 200 is diameter is 1000 millimeter needed, and 4000 length millimeter is needed. Okay, now there is a batch systems or a semi continuous process. There is a two types of process, continuous and semi continuous. Now we discuss the batch systems or semi continuous. During the high pressure process, the pressure is applied uniformly in all directions simultaneously, and this is known the isostatic pressures, and this is the reason why the food is not crushed during the treatment. Okay, got the point? And this is the major advantage compared to the thermal methods, where the product temperature is gradually increased. The high pressure vessels may be operated a vertical or horizontal. Okay, high pressure process batch equipments is there. Which equipments are needed for batch equipments? Okay, these are the equipments. See the processing semi-continuous high processings. Okay, or three vessels there. Okay, these are the pump. Okay, and these are product flow during the HPP process flow. Product is loading. These are the unprocessed batch. Product is loading, then vessel. Then the operating system is on. Okay. Now these are the all the processing and high pressure processing times. Okay. These are the time cycles. Okay. Firstly, the pressure is increased. Then second cycle, the pressure hold. Okay. Then pressure reduce. The finally. Okay. At that time, temperature also increased. Then pressure, temperature constant, little bit, and the pressure temperature should be decreases. Okay, these are the cycles. Okay, the typical high pressure process is, it is taken from the computer graphs from the high pressure processing systems. Okay, these are the came up times. Okay, these are the came up distance. Another holding times and the decompressions. Okay, the came up is the time required for the pressure of the treated sample to increase from the atmosphere pressure to pressure processing pressures. Okay, the came up time. Then the pressure should be held. Then the pressure volume is compressed. Okay. These are double cycles. Okay, two cycles is there. These are the power pack units. And these are the systems operated by computers screening. Okay, these are the vessels, chiller units. Okay, to cool the coil inside the vessels. The detailed components of these on the pressure vessels, condition fluid circuits. Okay, and these are the company. Okay, these are the company where the HPP is used. Then Holland is there, New York is there. Okay, Spain, UK, all the specifications there. Okay, this is the company named. The practical challenge in high pressure processing, the thermal effects during the high pressure processing, temperature increase that depends upon the initial temperature and materials compressibility and a specific heat and target pressure. Okay, the heating may be leading the getting food, the components and denatures of the protein and migration of the feed. Okay, these are the thermal effects. Thermal effects, little bit of thermal effect is there. How the high pressure process can preserve the food? Okay, similar to high temperature. Okay, as usual, high temperature used to decrease the pathogenic kill the pathogen bacteria. Also, it is used similar. Okay, and death of microorganism. Death of microorganism due to the permeabilization of cell membranes. Okay. Yes. All the combination of methods of broad resistance of microorganism bacteria spores. Effect of organelle sensory characteristics of the R little, if any. 400 megapascal used for structure and cytoplasmic organelles deform of the intercellular materials leaked out. Okay, but in case of 500 megapascal, nuclear could not be recognized. A loss of intercellular molecule was completed. This pascal pressure is affected. And also advantage of the safe workouts. Okay, uniformly penetration of pressure, instantaneously. Okay. HPP application area, pasteurization, sterilization, texture, all process. Juice, milk, okay. Juice, milk, feed, high pressure, low acid, fish, egg, proteins, all process, all product, food products are processed. You can process. Okay. Opportunity of high pressure processing of foods, high pressure blanching. Advantage of hot water or steam blanching without leaching and nutrition quality losses and environmental effects. High pressure and dehydration. In case of high pressure pre-treatments, 400 megapascal and 10 minutes, 25 degrees Celsius. A paprika resulted in increased the cell disintegrations, which resulted in a higher dehydration rates. In combination of high pressure and dehydration, okay. And high pressures of osmotic dehydration, high pressure treatments causes the more open tissues, architects or food tissues, which facilitates the enhance the mass transfer during the next step of osmotic dehydration. With high pressure and dehydration, high pressure pre-treated and osmotically flowed by air and drying resulted in food products having the reduce the leaching losses during the dehydration. Okay, reduce the leaching losses. High pressure and frying. Frying of high pressure blanched or processed foreign potatoes resulted in 40% reduction of oil content. Okay, 40% of reduction of oil content from the water blanched in foreign. If high pressure is used, the high pressure pre-treatments may affect the moisture or oil as well mass transfer mechanism. But in case of high pressure liquid, solid liquid extraction, extraction of caffeine from the coffee using the water can be increased by aid of a high pressure. Okay, caffeine increased. Okay, if the high pressure process is used, the yield also increased with temperature as well. The combination of pressure and temperature may prove to be the viable alternative to high temperature extraction process. Okay, this is the caffeine, this is the temperature. High pressure and preservation. Death of microorganism and inhibition of the enzyme make this a perfect alternative to the thermal processing. And death of microorganism due to permeabilization of cell membranes. Okay, preservation. HP treatment the enzymes related to the reverse and to the reversible and its irreversible changes the protein structures. Okay, losses of catalytic activity depends upon the types of enzymes and natures of substrate and temperature, also length of processing. Okay. Commercially pressurized food products currently available in international markets. And these are sensitive microorganisms, HP treated types of organism, yeast, molds, gram negatives, the low resistance. If yeast molds are there, the low resistance or pressure is yeast. Okay, high resistance requirement for bacteria spores or gram positive bacteria. Gram positive rod shaped bacteria in case of medium or low resistance are there. Okay. High pressure and gelation. Age high pressure induce the gels. What is this man? Okay, gels of protein and polysaccharides, and these gels could be created even at low temperature storage of kiwi and strawberry puri. Okay. Pressure assisted thermal processing, high pressure sterilization. The process, the packaging in flexible pouch. At first you packet the flexible pouch, then preheated 18 to 90 degrees Celsius. Then high pressure is 500 to 700. Okay, reaches to the 105 to 120 degrees Celsius due to the compression heatings. Okay. Hello Anirban or Devasis?
Hello sir.
Okay, but something is happening actually writing some
sir, you have to disable this option.
Yeah, disable participate annoyance. Okay. Okay, some commercial HP processed food is there. Okay. Well, these are the challenges which should be faced is there. Okay, material handling and package design. Material handling also highly superior. Okay, sanitization and cleaning also needed. Okay. Obstacles from the implementations of high pressure process. Okay, these are the already I give you the slide. Okay, don't worry. These are the conclusions. Okay, the recently commercial success. All these are the conclusions there. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Devasis.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Hi, sir. This is a notice for all. If any college presently or any person or any group want to arrange this type of program or have any proposal, please write to us, Foodtech Club and @rediffmail.com. Thanks to GP Vaga and GNIT to Royal Pattern in this EFST and CC19 season. Thank you, Dr. Kakkali Banayopadhya and Rahul Nayan sir for your kind proposal. Especially thank you, Sir Yedapal Dao and Sir Pratham Pau, Sir Neel Panal, Sir Amesh Naskar, Sir Karna Moni Dev, Sir Arnath, Sir Devanish Singh Dev, Sir Amit Thanke, Sir Swapnil Banerjee, Madam Priyanka Kajlal, Madam Vandana Dhake, Madam Nivedit Ma'am and our our exam and certification team, Sarpanak class marker, and a sponsored turn KLM Dutch Airlines. Safe with FTC, safe journey with KLM Dutch Airline. Then now I would like to request our second speaker, Mr. Saurabh Kumar and Sankhadeep Mukherjee. GP Bhaga, Dhanbad.
Good evening, everyone. I am going to give my speech among all of you today about the non-bacterial agent. Before that, I would like to introduce myself. I am Sankhadeep Mukherjee, a student of Government Polytechnic Bhaga, Dhanbad, Jharkhand. Today, I feel very good that I got this golden great opportunity because of Food Tech Club. Today is the last day of this webinar, and hence everyone would like to learn something new. So I will start with a little intro about our college. Our college, Government Polytechnic Bhaga, is the oldest college in Asia, known as Mining Institute Bhaga, Dhanbad. So let me start my presentation. Please, sir, host disabled attend. Sir, screen sharing. Hello. Can you hear me? Hello.
Yes, sir, I can hear you.
Sir, my screen sharing are not open.
Yes, sir.
Please make me co-host.
How you can?
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Non-bacterial agent of foodborne illness. They are considered in Helminthes, nematodes, protozoa, virus, and toxic metabolism of fungi and algae. Helminthes, there are number of animal parasites.
Hello,
which
sir. Hello. Sir, if you hold your phone in portrait mode, then it will be easy to see the file for us.
Okay, sir. Helminthes, there are number of animal parasites which can be transmitted to human via food and water. Many helminthes infection of human are recognized as zoonosis, and the route of infection invariably involve one of the pathogen's natural host having become a human food items. Some of these zoonotic infection are deadly, while other cause chronic ill health. The helminths include those transmitted by infected meat, fish, invertebrates and plants. Finally, a selection of approach to the prevention and control of foodborne helminth infection is presented. Now nematodes. Nematodes derive their name from Greek word meaning round town because of their shape. Trichinella spiralis is a widely spread nematode responsible for disease. Trichinellosis, the parasite has no free living stage, but it passes from host to host, including human and pigs. The disease is acquired from consumption of infected raw or poorly cooked pork products. especially SOGS. Infection starts by the consumption of muscles tissue containing insected larva in a cast with a calcified well. In the state, larva can survive for many years before eaten by a second host. In the second host, the larva are released and mature in the intestinal lumen. The female worm produces more than 1,000 larvae, which penetrate the gut wall and are carried to specific muscle tissue, in which they incised. Few days or months after eating the infected food, the symptoms of the disease appear in two stages. The first stage starts when larvae are invading the intestinal wall, producing abdominal pain, nausea, and diarrhea. The second phase occurs when larvae encase in muscle tissues, causing muscle pain, fever. And now protoza. The agglutinated protozoan Gyridia lamblia cause a non-invasive diarrhea of the small intestine. The transmission of the disease is associated usually with water or vegetables, or is transmitted from person to person by poor hygiene. The organism survives in food and water as caecist. The infected dose is very low, and once ingested, the gastric juice adds the release of the agglutinate active protozoa, which have 8 flagellate and 2 nuclei. The symptoms of the disease involve abdominal cramps, nausea, and diarrhea. The caecists are resistant to chlorination process used in most water treatment system, and are killed by the normal cooking procedures. Laboratory diagnosis depend largely on the microscopic identification of caecist or trophozoites. Trophozoites are present in stools during the acute phase of the diarrheal disease. Toxigenic fungi. The growth of commonly occurring filamentous fungi in food may result in producing of mycotoxins, which can cause a variety of ill effects in human, from allergic response to immune suppression and cancer. According to experts, 5 kinds of mycotoxins are important in human health around the world. Now, aflatoxins, ochratoxin A, fumensis, and chitin, trichinosis, and zearalenone. These toxins are produced by only a few species of fungi in a limited range of commodities. Commodities alpha toxin are potent carcinogens produced by Aspergillus flavus and A. Parasites in peanuts, maize, and some other nuts and oil seeds. Ochratoxin A is a kidney toxin and probable carcinogen. It is produced by Penicillium varicosum in cereals, grains in cold climates by a carbonaceous in grapes, wine, and wine fruits, and by a ochraceous sometimes in coffee beans, fermentations which may cause oestrogenic effect. Both are produced by F. germinarum and related species. Current reporting probably understanding the effect of mycotoxins as a cause of human mortality. Now, toxigenic algae. A number of planktonic algae can produce very toxic compounds which may be transferred to filter feeding shellfish such as mussel or small herbivorous fish which are food for longer carbon carnivorous fish. This toxin passed to human by consumption which are most toxic PSP. Paralytic shellfish poisoning NSP. Neurotoxic shellfish poisoning. The toxin in implicated in the various form of shellfish poisoning are not undetectable or organoleptically, but are also generally unaffected by cooking. Thank you. It is my short topic of the food non-bacterial agent. So thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank
you for your outstanding APD presentation. Thank you, sir.
Our next speaker, Saurabh Kumar. Sir, please come.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Sir, present his presentation.
Yeah, I present.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Good evening, respected sir, ma'am, and all the participants. Hello, my voice is audible. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. I, Saurabh Kumar, student of food technology from Government Polytechnic, Bhaga, Dhanbad, Jharkhand, India. I would like to say thanks to FTC Club for giving me chance to presenting the presentation on topic Introduction to Food Safety. So start our presentation. Firstly, we understand that what is food safety and why it is important. As per Food Safety Standard Act 2006, food safety refers to assurance that food is acceptable for human consumption according to its intended use. Food safety helps in prevention of food-borne illness that may cause due to improper handling, preparing or storage of food. Now next topic is food hazards. Biological, chemical and physical agents in the food with the potential to cause adverse health effects are called food hazards. Hazard may be caused in the food supply anytime during such as harvesting, formulation and processing, packaging and labeling, transportation, storage and preparation, and serving. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, you can.
Yeah. There are three type of hazards. First one is physical, second is chemical, and third is biological, or it's also called microbial. Physical hazards. Physical hazards are caused due to addition of any foreign object that may be added intentionally or unintentionally in the food. For example, here, broken pieces of metallics from crockery, long and dirty nails, etc. Now come on. Hello.
Yes, sir.
You can continue.
Hello, sir. Do you have any issue?
Hello.
Yes, sir. We can hear you.
Okay. For example, long and dirty nails, handling of food without wearing hair net and hand gloves, and many more, such as plastic films or foil jewelry, metallic pieces, dust, paste dropping, etc. Chemical hazards are caused due to any chemical which may be naturally occurring or process introduced chemical substance that may cause foodborne illness. Factors that may cause chemical hazards include cleaning products and sanitizer, pesticides, insecticides, rodenticides, colorants, lubricants, chemical food additives, preservatives, etc. Excessive use of chemical in food, intentionally or unintentionally, causes foodborne illness. Now the last is biological hazard. Biological hazard occurs when food gets contaminated by microorganisms found in the air, foods, water, soil, animals, and human body. Here are some examples of biological hazards, chemical hazards, and physical hazards. In biological hazards, some examples are bacteria, viruses, molds, yeast, and parasites. And in chemical, MSG, food colors, additives, essence, and in physical, such as pins, plastic, hair, paper, glass, etc. Many organisms are essential for life itself. However, given the right condition, some microorganisms cause foodborne illness. Now the next topic is allergens. An allergen is any substance eaten or inhaled which causes allergic reaction due to hypersensitivity of the immune system toward it. Nowadays, lot of people have food allergy consumption of certain food mainly to allergic reaction in human body, which are hazardous. Some common food allergens are nuts, peanuts, dairy products, shellfish, mollusks, eggs, sesame seeds, soya, and certain food additives. It is important to provide allergen information to the consumer, and the measure to control food hazard should be established at the stage of food handling to prevent ensuring food safety and prevent food from spoilage. Now it is very big very big question is, what is food spoilage? Food spoilage is the process in which the food quality, texture, nutritional value of the food get deteriorates and become unfit for human consumption. Major reason of food spoilage are foreign matter, use of non-food grain equipment, improper handling of food, improper processing, residues of chemical, uses of poor raw material, etc. Major reason of food spoilage, and each must be controlled while food handling. Next are foreign matter, non-food grain equipment, lubricant that's found in lubricants that found in equipment of machineries, etc. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your outstanding APD presentation.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, and Ankadeep Murji. Thank you so much. Now I would like to request our first speaker, Mr. Rohan Sarkar, National Institute of Technology. Sir, you here?
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
So should I start with the presentation?
Yes, sir.
Okay, just a minute. slide visible?
Yes, sir.
Good evening. Good evening, everyone. Today.
Hello.
Hello. Hello, everybody. Do you listen to me?
Hello.
Yes, Anivan.
Achha, okay. Actually, today's session is not only our training session, and this is the training session for our the mini speaker. Okay. Actually, they are very new, and actually they are the first presentation for this Rohan, Shankardeep, Shourav. Okay, so in this matter, so this is a new your prayer. Please, everybody, I request you to please pray to God for their success. Okay, this is not any the part of training. They are representing their presentation for their own interest and for their professional development. Okay, so do not think that this is a part of the our training. Okay.
Sir, may I continue, sir?
Yeah, continue.
Yes, sir. You can.
Yeah. So, is the slide visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So today, there is an interactive session on COVID-19 food safety, and it is the sixth day of our Food Tech Club's food safety initiative, supported by GP Bhaga, Government of Jharkhand, and JNIT Kolkata. But that doesn't really feel like much, because we have sort of been habituated with this presumably unimaginable situation. And trust issues have become more common than ever. From local to global, the business have either shut down or shed their operations and workforce. On the ground level, the farmer who seeds the soil is unable to reap the harvest due to lack of manpower, due to lack of machinery. Food safety is now a matter of serious concern. So we'll be discussing the topic and agenda. Let's move on to the next slide. The agenda of discussion today are the following points: understanding coronavirus, the symptoms and spread, responsibilities of FBO, food business operators. I'll be referring to food business operators as FBO, preventive measures to be taken by the food industry, like physical distancing, personal hygiene, cleaning and sanitation. And later we'll talk about the government precautions that are to be enacted. So what is the coronavirus? The coronavirus is a large family of viruses whose basic structure resembles a crown, not like the Indian ornamental crown. It's more of a typical specific English crown, like the round English crown we used to see in our storybooks. So the shape of the virus resembles a crown, hence the name coronavirus. The novel coronavirus causes the disease COVID-19. And the name of the virus is SARS-CoV-2. The index case was first reported in Wuhan's seafood and animal market. It is very much possible that the virus has jumped into human in the course of human food chain. Symptoms include mild to extreme fever, cough, dry or wet, but I won't be discussing the symptoms. But the point to be underlined is the method of spread of the disease. The method of propagation of the disease is similar to the MERS disease, Middle East Respiratory Syndrome. The COVID-19 also spreads through droplet transmission. As you can see in this picture, the person who is coughing is actually spreading the droplets of the virus into the atmosphere around him. So everyone around him in the vicinity of 1 meter would be very likely to catch the virus and get infected of it. Then comes the question, does COVID-19 spread through food? Well, so far there is no reported evidence that COVID-19 transmits through food, including the poultry and seafood. However, like other viruses, like the SARS-CoV-2 can survive on surfaces or objects. Like we know that the virus survives on surfaces of copper, of metal, of plastic, cardboard in various times. So it is survivable on the surface, but there is no supportable evidence that it spreads through food. It is the responsibility of the FBO to follow good GMP, good manufacturing practices, and GHP, good hygiene practices. These are prescribed in Schedule 4 of Food Safety Regulations 2011. So to create a robust hygienic food production plan, we need to enact certain advisories as FBOs. Physical distancing of at least 1 meter between each personnel at the production facility. So 1 meter of distance, physical distancing, is what we have to maintain at all costs. Then comes thermal screening. Thermal screening at the entry to detect the symptoms of mild or high fever, cough, dry or wet. Stringent personal hygiene by regular hand wash, application of face masks and gloves, and deep cleaning and sanitation. So this part includes the processes of cleaning and as well as disinfection, followed by sanitation by competent professionals to ensure sanitized manufacturing environments with certifications. So we will be emphasizing on the fact that we need professionals who can perform the processes of sanitation and disinfection. These are all the responsibilities of FBO. Now let's take a broader aspect into the responsibilities of an FBO. I'll be discussing the managerial responsibilities first. The responsibility would be conducting awareness training. So we need to aware the food handlers on symptoms, spread, and company safety protocols, personal hygiene, social distancing. It is the duty, the responsibility of the FBO to conduct the awareness training to all the food handlers in the production facility. Then comes regular screening. Regular screening of all personnel entering the premises for fever, cough, shortness of breath. These should be the symptoms that should be screened. So every personnel who is entering the premises should be screened for these symptoms. Now coming on to the moral responsibilities. In the moral responsibilities of an FBO, suppose someone of you is having a poultry farm, someone of you is controlling a beverage bottling manufacturing plant. So including everyone who is a food business operator, we should just maintain these few managerial and moral responsibilities in the times of pandemic to control food hygiene. The moral responsibilities include encouraging employees to come forward to inform or declare if they are having any kind of, if they are experiencing any kind of symptoms, or if there is some other problem. It is the duty of the employer to maintain the encouragement among the employees to come up with their problems. And assurance of assistance and job protection, especially in the lower income group. So the low income group workers of the food manufacturing plant are the most vulnerable to this disease or to any kind of adversity. So they should be taken care of, and so that the employee doesn't have to fear of losing the job or any kind of discriminatory behavior after recovery. So it is the responsibility of the FBO. It is needless to mention that the employer needs to be aware and sensitive about the worker's salary, leave, and health, both physical and mental, and also his or her safety. So these are the responsibilities of FBO. These are the steps that necessarily imply the fact that prevention is better than cure. However, in a situation of pandemic, we must also be prepared for the unprecedented. There is a high chance of workers having contacted the virus or fall sick of it. When detected, the FBO must be ready with a predetermined diagnostic plan. We know what is diagnostics when something goes wrong and we have to check that however possible. So we need to be prepared. In the first sense, we have to prepare a diagnostic plan. So what are the first steps to establish a diagnostic plan? Establish a local emergency response team. This is a very important term, local emergency response team, and nominate a COVID-19 coordinator. So these two are very important. The team would be the diagnostic team and the heading would be of COVID-19 coordinator. He is actually nominated. The team has to devise a set of protocols. So the set of protocols is to be designed by the team. And what are the protocols that are suggested? Number one, list of local authorized hospitals for testing and treatment. So it is quite self-explanatory. List of local authorized hospitals that are taking COVID-19 patients. The list needs to be informative enough to save time during crisis. And the contact numbers should be present with the COVID-19 coordinator. So at all costs, the COVID-19 coordinator is liable with any kind of decision making. Contact details of professional disinfectant agency. This is very necessary at this time. Whether or not someone is infected, the disinfectant agency might be brought for scheduled sanitation and discussing faults to ensure the aseptic environment during production or packaging. Third, dedicated masks, gloves, and other personal protection equipment, PPE, are kept and available for emergency situations. I'll focus on the fact that these are dedicated masks and gloves and other PPE. We will have to use these items on a regular basis, on a day-to-day basis, but these should be separate from the regular use items. These should be untouched before being supplied to the employees. By any means, shortage of equipment to combat the virus may lead to a menace, right? So one person susceptible to the virus is an overall risk to the food and other employees, as well as the food company. Number four, isolation rooms, one for suspected cases, one for close contacts, are prepared with special bins. And they are talking about the dust bins. So isolation rooms should be created for suspected cases and for this close contacts also, come in close contact with the suspected ones. And the seats in isolation must be kept at a certain distance. We can't just keep them congested in this isolation room also, because by far we don't know that who might actually have been infected. It is recommended to maintain isolation facilities for about 1/4 of the total workforce, and food and water are the top priority. They should get food and water, and also the FBO, who is actually anxious about the company and employees. So they should arrange for at least 1/4 of the total workforce. So isolation rooms for at least 1/4 of the workforce. Now, number fifth, record keeping of all attendance, health status, visitors, etc. We know record keeping is very important. Some organizations have already halted the biometric attendance system for now to avoid infection. And we should also focus on avoiding such common high touch points to stop or check the spread of the disease. And number sixth, detailed record keeping of confirmed cases covering whole incident process, information to local authorities, actions taken by the company. These are three parts. So detailed record keeping of what? The confirmed cases covering whole incident process, the incident process, how he got infected, how he started feeling the symptoms, and when did he think of informing the authorities, information to the local authorities, how did he pass on, and the actions that were taken by the company after retrieval of the information that someone is infected in the plant. So the entire record keeping is a must. Record keeping is a must because and it should be in a tabular form, tabular pattern. Record keeping should always be in a structured form because unstructured data is difficult to process and even difficult to share. So try to jot down certain columns for contact tracing. Record keeping will give the FBOs the information that will enable them to determine isolation measures and further deep cleaning activities also. So I'll be moving on to the next slide. I hope I'm keeping with the pace. Personal hygiene for food handlers. See, food handlers are the ones that will be handling the food in any production facility. And they are to be maintained with the stringent personal hygiene. They should maintain this at all costs. As we can see in the bubbles, there are 5 hygiene protocols: hand wash, sanitizers, good respiratory hygiene, frequent cleaning and disinfection, and no close contact. These are the 5 rules. Hand wash for a minimum of 20 seconds as per WHO guidelines, preferably followed by sanitation with 70% alcohol or equivalent. 70% alcohol is very much necessary after the hand wash of 20 seconds as per WHO guidelines. Staff must wash and sanitize their hands after changing their outdoor clothes also and before wearing the clean clothes at work. So there should be 2 sets of clothes, one for the work and one for traveling from home and to the work. So there should be 2 sets of clothes, face mask, cover, and clean protective clothing must be worn by all. No gaps should be observed after wearing the mask/cover. The sentence is self-explanatory. I don't need to explain it. The face masks should be changed every 6 hours or as soon as they get wet. The mistake that we make that we tend to change the face mask a lot later, but we should be changing the face masks every 6 hours or as soon as they get wet. Reusable masks should be washed and sanitized. And disposal of the masks must be done separately in closed bins. Okay, there should not be the masks scattering here and there. One of them might be infected with the virus and it can cause serious crisis in the production facility. The disposal of the mask must be done separately in a closed bin. And paper bag may be preferably used to put used face covers before disposal. You just grab a paper bag and put the face mask inside it and then throw it in the closed bin. Gloves. Strict implementation of no jewelry, no watch policy. Sanitize mobile phones after entry at work. No jewelry, obviously. You can't allow jewelry and other items, including watches, that are prone to infection, that are contagion. And sanitize mobile phones after entry at work. Mobile phones are the most infectious devices around you. You touch them from morning to night and it is being touched now and then. So they are the most contagious devices that are around you. And it is recommended to sanitize the mobile phones after entry at work or whenever possible. Gloves to be worn during handling of ready-to-eat food. When the food is almost ready to eat, now at that stage, there is just the food which is kept untouched. So no other surface is to be touched after touching the food, or we can't just touch other surfaces and touch the food since it is ready to eat. So we'll have to be careful about that. That during food, during handling of ready-to-eat food, no other surface should be touched. And there is a very important point which says, note that wearing gloves may give false sense of security. There is no substitute to hand washing and sanitizing to prevent COVID-19. So as the sentence says, there is no substitute to hand washing. I hope you can understand. You'll have to wash hands and sanitize your hands at all costs. There is no such thing that wearing gloves will make a great wall in front of you from the virus, and the virus won't be able to catch your hands. It's not like that. You'll have to hand wash and sanitize your hands to prevent COVID-19. Moving on to the next slide. Personal hygiene. Respiratory hygiene shall be adhered by covering mouth, nose while coughing. Dispose of the tissue in closed trash bin. As I already said, you'll have to dispose the tissue in a closed trash bin. And even the face masks, the used face masks in closed trash bin. Reporting of illness. Encourage workers to stay at home. If they are showing symptoms like coughing, fever, breathlessness, etc. So if a worker is having such symptoms and he has called over the phone to inform the authorities about the about his condition, so illness reporting on the phone should be accepted. If he is on the phone and he is having such symptoms, we should not be just call him or her to work and let the person have the time to isolate, self-isolate, and observe himself or herself if he or she is having the symptoms. And after prolonged symptoms, he will be naturally contacting the health authorities and isolate the person if they have flu-like symptoms while at work, and inform the authority. Anyone who is at work and having such symptoms must be isolated so that other employees don't get infected by him or her. And personal close to infected person must do self-quarantine and isolate as per government rules. The personnel who are very much close to the infected person must isolate themselves. And isolated persons should be dedicated with toilets. They should have dedicated toilets for themselves, and washing area also. They should have these two separate facilities, dedicated toilets and washing area. The responsibility of FBO is not just limited to creating a emergency response team and a COVID-19 coordinator, but also he should maintain such hygienic practices for personal hygiene. As we can see, the discontinued use of biometric fingerprints, sharing of belongings, for example, gloves, jackets, common stationery, pens, work tools, etc., during the pandemic period. So we should not be sharing stuffs in the workplace. Keep everyone's tools and pens and other gloves, jackets, other tools. These should be of separate use. We shouldn't just share them. Food premises, toilets, counters, equipments, etc. that came in contact with the infected persons shall be thoroughly cleaned with hot water and detergent. Hot water should be presumably of 60 degrees centigrade, and the area should be disinfected by 1% or 0.1% hypochlorite solution or any equivalent. Now, these are two posters, how to hand rub and how to hand wash. I know every one of you is smart enough to know how hand is washed and hand is rubbed with sanitizers, but this is not to show you or make you believe that this is the steps, but you can just take these posters as an example, as a display to show the workers in the facility to how to hand rub and how to hand wash. They should be the ones who should be demonstrated with the processes, and these posters will be helpful enough. We know hand rub duration of entire procedure takes about 20 to 30 seconds, and show them, demonstrate to the workers how hand is rubbed with sanitizers, and also the same case goes with hand wash. These are the posters available on the WHO website. You can get them easily. Social distancing. The term social distancing is somewhat I have personally never heard of till 2019. But as we learned to live with the virus, we understood that it is not possible to hide from the virus and stay at home. This is the reason nations around the world have opened up their factories. Thus, social distancing becomes a very vague term when operating as a team. So physical distancing, not social distancing, can be the solution. What are the steps? What are the necessary steps that we need to follow to maintain physical distancing at the workforce, at the workplace? And these are the points. Minimize physical contacts between two persons. Minimum distance is to be maintained 1 meter. 1 meter distance is to be maintained at all costs. Only 3 to 4 employees in an area of 10 feet at any given point of time. More people, more than 4 people shouldn't be gathering at any area. Stagger workstations, food preparation area. Review the speed of production lines. If you need to just slow them, if you need to close few production lines, you may. Review shift arrangements to cause at least less amount of congestion during the work times. Limit number of people. This also includes drivers, cleaners, customers, and use spacing measures like stickers, tapes, markers to maintain the distance at all places. This is a very widely accepted process now, and you can see this in banks, in shopping malls, that they are using stickers, tapes, and markers to maintain the distance, and the customers are usually very obedient enough, right? Use such spacing measures, and prohibit sharing of lockers. So both Ram and Sham shouldn't be having the same lockers. They should be provided with separate lockers so that their stuffs, their whatever their belongings are, they don't get intermingled, and they don't share any kind of disease or contagion. Food delivery personnel should leave the packet at 1 meter distance at customer's door. Take it off a Zomato no contact delivery guy. So he should necessarily keep the distance of 1 meter from the customer's door. Do not hand over the food packet directly to the customer. Takeaways should be encouraged instead of dine-in. We know dine-in, when we go to a restaurant and we enjoy the environment and we listen to a lot of music from there and just eat our lunch or dinner at the place. But at the time of pandemic, we should encourage takeaways, deliveries, not dine-in. We want to make our customers enjoy our food at home. So stay at home, and takeaways should be encouraged. Face-to-face meetings are restricted as much as possible. We must restrict face-to-face meetings, as I am currently avoiding a face-to-face meeting with each one of you. So physical distancing should be the key. Now coming on to our next slide, which is cleaning and sanitation. See, cleaning and sanitation is, they are like the same coin with both faces. Well, first of all, we need to clean any surface, then only we can sanitize it. We often make this mistake that we use sanitizers without prior washing or cleaning our hands. And it is absolutely unacceptable and without any benefit. No points to guess why. Because you'll have to first moisten or rinse the surface and then only you can sanitize it. You can't sanitize a dirty surface. Cleaning should always come at first. The equipments, containers, utensils, cutlery, etc. should be thoroughly cleaned with soap and water, and always hot water is recommended, which is above 60 degrees centigrade. What are the areas that should be cleaned with soap and water? Food preparation, production area, stores, packaging area, service area, waste disposal area, office space, and transport vehicle. So we shouldn't be missing with any of these. On the left hand, we have the high touch points, which are the sensitive areas prone to high viral contagion on a day-to-day basis. We need to identify such points as soon as possible and carry out the cleaning and sanitation process as shown in the right column. So in the left column, we have the high touch points, and we'll be discussing the processes of sanitation, their method and frequency in the right column. We have the high touch points, diary files, keyboards, mouse, elevator buttons, handrails, call buttons, escalator handrails, public counters, intercom systems, telephones, tabletops, tea, coffee dispensing machines, etc. These should be cleaned twice a day by mopping. You'll have to mop the surface with absorbable cloth or linen cloth soaked in 1% sodium hypochlorite solution. Metallic surfaces like door handles, security locks, handles of baskets, carts, display racks, where bleach is not suitable. These are metallic surfaces, and these are easily eroded away if bleaching is done. So we'll avoid bleaching there and instead use 70% alcohol to clean the surface. Hand sanitizing stations at the entry and near high contact surfaces. These stations, which are responsible for the dispensing of hand sanitizers to the personnels coming into the production facility, should also be cleaned. So cleaned, they should be cleaned at least twice in a shift. Per shift, they should be cleaned twice and sanitized with 1% sodium hypochlorite. Now we have three columns. First is the type of the sanitizer, which is first we have chlorine, and then we'll be talking about its use, and at the last, the frequency. Chlorine can be used on perishable products and food contact surfaces. So chlorine, we just use its nascent properties to disinfect surfaces, and when it is used in food contact surfaces, it disinfects the food, and it can be used always for food to be consumed raw after use. Then we have quaternary methyl butyric acid, QMBA. It is also used on food contact surfaces. Then we have 70% alcohol based sanitizer. These can be used for hand sanitization and sanitization of common touch points and food contact surfaces. And its frequencies as when required after each use. See, these are the chemicals as direction. Use chemicals as per direction of your manufacturer. This is just a suggestive list that I've prepared. And there is no ABC of hand sanitizers. You can use any of your choice. You can talk with your manufacturer. You can talk with your FBO. what kind of sanitizer or cleaning fluids you might use. But this is just a suggestive list. There are more chemical-based disinfectants available in the market. And cleaning process should be followed by disinfection. This is the important note. Now we'll be talking about no contact delivery. No contact delivery, we have heard the term. And in the coronavirus care, you must maintain certain rules to maintain the sanctity of no contact delivery. What are the three important rules? Practice social distancing, number one. Number two, cashless payment. And number three, avoid contact with common touch points. If the food delivery personnel is touching certain parts of the delivery package, you must touch the other points. Try to avoid those points and try to touch the other part of the delivery package, and thereby avoid common touch points and always go for cashless payment. Don't go for cash payment because it is more prone to infections. Now, food packaging. This is an interesting chart. Coronavirus average surface retention time. This is the time required by the virus to die on its own on certain surfaces. On copper, it stays for the minimum time. If the coronavirus is on copper, it usually stays for about 4 hours. On aluminium, it survives for 2 to 8 hours, 24 hours on cardboard, 2 to 3 days on stainless steel, 2 to 3 days on plastics, 4 days on wood, 5 days on paper, glass, 5 days on ceramics, and 5 days on metal. Cleaning, sanitizing, disinfection measures are to be adopted to ensure that food packaging is kept clean and away from sources of contamination. As we know, food packaging protects the food from a variety of pathogens and quality degrading ingredients. But in the context of coronavirus, we must focus on the time that is required by the virus to wear out or die on these surfaces. This is the retention time, and this varies from 4 hours as on copper to 5 days as on ceramics, metals, etc. Moving on to the next slide. Protocols for COVID-19. So these are the protocols. When an employee tests positive for COVID-19 or is showing symptoms associated with COVID-19, when symptoms are seen but testing is not done, so on the basis of symptoms, we'll be taking these protocols. We'll be following these protocols. Recommended to stay home and be excluded from work until they are free of symptoms for at least 3 days without the use of fever reducing or other symptom altering medicines like paracetamol and cough suppressants. See, the first point is very important. Recommend the workers who were having symptoms to stay at home. And if they don't have symptoms for consecutive 3 days, then only they might be permitted to come to work, and they should be in healthy state without the use of fever reducing or other symptom altering medicines like paracetamol. We know paracetamol is a medicine which actually suppresses the fever, and similarly cough suppressants. We know cough syrups are of two types: cough expectorants and cough suppressants. So cough suppressants are the ones which are responsible to relieve our cough symptoms. So they should be free from these medicines and be healthy at all costs for 3 days consecutively. Then only they might be permitted. And the second point says, at least 7 days have passed since symptoms first appeared. So after 7 days from the date that he reported the symptoms, then only he can be allowed. Employees should notify their supervisor. Encourage the employee to contact their local health authority and seek medical attention upon initial appearance of symptoms. So as soon as the symptoms start to appear, the employees should be encouraged by the FBOs to contact local health authority. Now we have, when an employee tests positive for COVID-19 or is showing symptoms associated with COVID-19. Employees with a COVID-19 positive test who have stayed home, isolated or treated in a hospital may be allowed to return to work under the following conditions. So these are the conditions that a worker who had been recently susceptible to the virus, he had the symptoms and might have been tested positive. So we'll be looking for these three conditions to be satisfied in order for the person to return to work. These are the three conditions. Number one, no longer have a fever without the use of medicine and that reduce fevers. I have already stated without the use of paracetamols, they shouldn't be having a fever. Second, other symptoms have improved. For example, cough and shortness of breath have improved. They have relief from cough and they don't have the symptoms of shortness of breath. And number three, this is a very important condition, received two negative tests in a row, 24 hours apart. So they should be having tested at least two negative tests. They should have at least come up with two negative tests for COVID-19 and not on the same day, but 24 hours apart. If the employee is on site at the facility and he's showing the symptoms of the virus, notify the administrative or health authorities for further protocol. If the employee is at home, do not permit the employee to come to work. And when the symptoms are seen, but testing is not done, we have already discussed the steps to follow. Now, I'll be concluding my presentation. With utmost care is the only cure. I believe carelessness only shows what we don't value. And at the time of crisis, it can lead to an epidemic in no time. I'd like to share a very interesting story of JRD Tata, Jahangir Ratanji Dadabhai Tata, who was one of the chairmen of the Tata Sons group. So he had a friend who used to lose or misplace his pen very often. And he had a very, very nasty habit of losing pens, actually. So one day he told JRD Tata that about his habit, and JRD Tata advised him to buy the most costliest pen that he can afford. So he just thought a bit and agreed to him somehow. And about six months later, when JRD Tata met him again, he asked him whether he has the same habit of losing and misplacing his pens. To his surprise, he replied, he is surprised how he has changed. He doesn't lose his pen now. So JRD then explained to him that it is not the fact that the value of the pen has made the difference in the person. It is his carefulness. Now he is more careful about his belongings, his assets. And we should also be careful about our assets. Our primary asset is our health. So we should be careful about our health at all costs. And the FBOs need to be careful about the hygienic production operations, employees about their personal health, and employers about the health of the employees. Then only we can beat this epidemic condition. Thank you. I'd like to conclude my presentation. If you have any queries, you can ask, or you can mail me or WhatsApp me in the following number. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your outstanding paper presentation. Is there a request to everyone if you have any questions regarding this APD presentation, you can ask. Sir, already we have some question. A question from Sunil. Sir, if I will use isopropyl alcohol to disinfect or sanitize surface, in that case, can we sanitize surface with isopropyl alcohol directly instead of 70% alcohol based sanitizer on need to make it 70% alcohol based sanitizer?
Okay. See, we need to dilute the isopropyl alcohol at 70% concentration, and it is recommended for because see, every product of alcohol has its separate and unique composition and alcohol content also. So whatever you find the product in the market which is used for any specific function, there is always a specific alcohol content. And for hand sanitizers and to be actually able to remove the virus and kill the virus in the hands, it is recommended to maintain the 70% alcohol content in the hand sanitizers.
Okay, thank you, sir. I don't see any other questions regarding this presentation. Thank you, sir.
Is there any other query? Thank you, sir. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for being such a wonderful sport and tolerating me for this big amount of time.
Thank you, sir. So what do you, Ajal Kumari?
Okay, I think we have a query. Can we use 90% alcohol for cleaning? See, we can. But actually 70% IPA is recommended because why not 60% or why not 90%? Because with it has some functions. It kills the antimicrobial, it has the antimicrobial properties which kills bacteria, fungi and viruses. Once the alcohol concentration is below 50%, the disinfection usefulness actually drops. So notably higher concentrations of alcohol will be having the more bactericidal properties and other fungicidal properties. But 70% IPA is recommended because it has some connection to the permeability of the cell. Okay, so it is more dependent on the permeability of the cell, and actually 70% is necessary. So you can't use 90% alcohol. We'll have to stick with the 70% alcohol only.
Thank you, sir. Hello.
Okay. If there is any other query, you can always mail me. I'll give you the mail and you can find my WhatsApp number also. You can ask any kind of queries. You can just mail me and I'll give the PPT also. You don't have to worry about anything.
Yes, sir. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, sir, for wonderful presentation.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Here.
If there are any other queries, then I'll be
okay, sir.
I hope there isn't. Okay. So the next presentation would be started in a few minutes.
No, last presentation. Your presentation is last.
The presentation of Rohan is so nice and so beautiful and so I think that everybody like it very much.
So make me co-host.
Ashish this present hai na?
Yes, okay. Sir.
Okay. Very nice picture.
Is it visible?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you from Guru Nanak Institute of Technology, GNIT, Kolkata?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good.
Yes, sir.
How are you?
I am fine, sir.
Okay. Are you ready for your...
Yes, sir, I am ready. Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. So, good evening, everyone. I'm Srijita Shaha. I'm from Guru Nanak Institute of Technology. Today my topic is physical and chemical contaminants and additives. So, the content of presentations are introduction, sources of chemical contaminants in food, the reasons for chemical food contamination, types of food contaminants, naturally occurring contaminants in food, contamination during the food production, processing, storage, and preparation phases. So let's come to the introduction of this topic. So what is food contamination? Food contamination is a matter of serious concern as the high concentration of chemicals present in the edibles poses serious health risks. The food contamination could be due to naturally occurring contaminants in the environment or artificially introduced by the human. The phases of food processing, packaging, transportation, and storage are also significant contributors to food contamination. Therefore, a variety of food needs to be inspected and measured for the presence of chemical contaminants. The preventive measures pertaining about the food contaminants problems are pointed out and discussed. So, chemical contaminants inhibit almost the mass-produced everyday use products such as disinfectants, plastics, detergents, deodorants, pesticides, and so on. So the sources of chemical contaminants in food. So we get the chemical contaminants from the foods mainly as a result of using the agrochemicals such as residues of pesticides and veterinary drugs, contamination from environmental sources like water, air or soil pollution, cross-contamination or formation during food processing, migration from food packaging materials, and the presence or contaminant by natural toxin or use of unapproved food additives and adulterants. So the reasons for food contamination. So food is crucial contributor to human health, well-being, and a major source of worry, pleasures, and stress. With one of the reasons behind the stress and worry are the diseases caused as a result of contaminated food. There are multiple reasons for the contamination of food. Food preparation undergoes through a long chain of processing, where each stage is a potential source of chemical contaminants invasion of the food. Transportation of food can also lay the foundation of contamination of food, especially under poor sanitary conditions. Likewise, some chemicals are mixed deliberately during the food preparation process to improve the shelf life of a food product. The contaminants may include impurity foods when cooked in the kitchen. The transmission is mainly dependent on the effectiveness of the kitchen hygiene, though. Chemical contaminants enter the food chain naturally as well with the pathogens that are present in the environment and show high bacterial numbers on some key raw foods as a poultry meat. So the types of food contaminants, there are four types of food contamination like chemical contamination, microbial contamination, physical contamination of food, and the allergenic food contamination. So these are the examples of the contaminations, and the contamination occurs like the source of contamination and then transfer of bacteria, then potentially hazardous foods, and then the time and warmth allow bacteria to grow, then the food is eaten, and then the food causes food poisoning. And here are some lists of naturally occurring contaminants in food. And the contamination during the food production, processing, storage, and preparation phases. Like food contamination can come from different situations. A wide overview is presented in the paper, where the different steps applied to food from the reception of raw materials to the final food intake by consumers are shown. Among the sources involved in the food contamination process, the following ones can be highlighted, like external raw food contamination due to environmental contamination. B, transport of raw materials to the factory where they will be processed. C, food conditioning, which involves the storage of raw materials, preheating, disinfection, cleaning, and sanitization steps. Like in this figure 1, we are showing that the food contamination, how it is occurred, and the B, contamination due to the environmental influences. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. For your such outstanding presentation.
Thank you.
Okay.
Okay, Anivandar, now. Yeah, it's last. Now, if you have any.
Do you have any problem about our session?
Yeah.
Anybody tell me? सब आदमी को स्पीकर ना ऑन कर दो पहले देवाशीष
क्या करता हूँ
देवाशीष
एक मिनट रुको या आई एम डूइंग इट नाउ एवरीवन कैन अनम्यूट देमसेल्फ
आप लोगों का कोई कॉम्प्लेन है? Have any complaint? Have any suggestion for our session?
I think nobody have any type of complaint against this program. So officially, Anivanda, and we stop this program now.
Any inquiry after the examination and certification? Hello. Please tell me. Hello.
Okay, Anivanda, now Vijay Kumar asked a question. Sir, please tell us about tomorrow test, about schedule. Sir, tomorrow is not our test. The test schedule will be rescheduled, and after reschedulation, the test will be held at 13th
July 2020. Monday, okay, aapko raat 12 baje after 2 a.m. you will start to take your text, okay? You will give examination for 2 hours and full mark 200, okay? And our examination controller has the noun Jasmine Arabi. I hope that 75% people will crack our cutoff mark. Okay.
Okay. So on next question from Mitali Shah. What will be our study material? For this question, ma'am, the study material depends on our PPT and our video.
We will share our lecture video. That will be definitely helpful to your examination. Okay.
Mitali Shah asked a question. Examination at 2 a.m.
No, actually.
I'm 2 a.m.
Actually, 2 a.m. This the question will be available for our still midnight. Okay. Just for the 12 o'clock, you can attend any time in 2 hours, but it will be the only one chance. रात 12 बजे तक नेक्स्ट डे रात 12 बजे तक एग्जामिनेशन हमारा क्लास मार्क में ओपन होगा. आपको वन टाइम 2 घंटा का एग्जामिनेशन आप दे सकते हो. ऑल टाइम आप मॉर्निंग में भी दे सकते हो, नाइट में भी दे सकते हो, शाम में भी दे सकते हो. दैट इज योर मैटर. ओके,
बट
आपको बस एक
ही, यू कैन अटेंड ओनली वन
चांस. आपको दो टाइम कोशिश करोगे तो ऑटोमेटिकली आपको आंसर सीट हमारा पास नहीं आएगा. ओके
ओके, देन नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम रिफत, दैट व्हाट इज द पैटर्न ऑफ द क्वेश्चन, इज इट एमसीक्यू? यस मैम, इट्स एब्सोल्युटली अबाउट एमसीक्यू. द क्वेश्चन विल एज एन एमसीक्यू pattern. Okay, next Fatima Uzmila, she asks that can we get day one, class three, A2, class three PPT. Ma'am,
noted this point. There was noted this point and try to help her.
So Deepkantol Alal asks that कितने क्वेश्चन होंगे और कैसे टाइप का होंगे, मतलब
200 क्वेश्चन का होगा, एमसीक्यू होगा, हमारा पीपीटी का साथ मतलब नहीं है, लेक्चर के ऊपर डिपेंड करता है क्या लेक्चर में क्या बोला,
उनके ऊपर डिपेंड करता है, उसका होगा। तो इसलिए हम लोग ये डिसाइड किए, मतलब
आप लोगों के पास पीपीटी शेयर करने कोई फायदा नहीं होगा, आपको मैं हम लोग वीडियो शेयर कर दूंगा, ठीक है।
नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, नेक्स्ट सजेशन, इट्स लाइक सजेशन, एक सजेशन फ्रॉम फ्रॉम अनूप सर दैट प्लीज शेयर ऑल पीपीटी एज अ ग्रेड, थैंक्स।
ओके, डेफिनेटली विल डू। आज कल से सब शुरू होगा, ऑलरेडी प्रिपरेशन लो, ले लो।
अमी हैज टू फाइडस आस्क्ड अ क्वेश्चन ऑन व्हिच बेसिस सर्टिफिकेट विल बी गिवन। Anivanda, are you able to hear me?
Yeah.
He asks that on which basis
certificate will be provided on basis of the cutoff mark. Before we have certified our students 68%. In this matter, we increase the 7.5%. So we hope that 75% will be provided. We will provide certificate for the 75% people.
Okay, okay. Our next suggestion from Fatema.
We need to create Tuzmila, that cutoff.
Next suggestion from Fatema Tuzmila that there was a net problem of SAR and M sides. That classes was postponed day one class three. And day two class three. In that case, ma'am, day one class three registered from animation Oscar. Definitely, we will provide his PPT. But day two class three suggested for Srijita Shah. I think Srijita Shah already. Presented her PPT presentation today. So, day two, class three already held.
Yes, class marked. Right.
Akriti Datta. Yes, class marked. What will be the test platform?
Classmarker.com.
Classmarker, sir. Okay, so Anivanda, I think we will officially end this webinar.
Okay, yes.
And once again, thank you negative to everyone.
In the
thank
you test,
for
no.
staying with us.
No negative mark.
Yeah, definitely. And thank you for staying with us. Is a
share link text through the group. Support. No, sorry. No link for test. No link for test.
Yeah.
Only on class mark.
Okay, Anivanda. So
only on your class mark profile.
Okay.
So. One extra cost for the class mark. Don't know. I'm not cannot tell link share with you.
Absolutely. So there is a request to all of the candidates, if you have any type of problem regarding our test, you can ask on our WhatsApp group. Thank you and thanks for staying with us. It's a lovely support from all of your sites. Thank you and have a good night.